Welcome to the Solar Decathlon. We're here on the very first day. All 19 teams from around the world are coming to this site to set up their competition homes. These are university schools of architecture and engineering that have designed ground-up houses that are energy efficient and solar powered. It's the culmination of a two-year project, and we're here today to start building these houses within 7 days. The Solar Decathlon gets its name from 10 contests that we judge these houses and also will measure their performance. But the first key is to get these houses built within 7 days, get them competition ready. Behind me you see a construction site where these teams are bringing their houses from their campuses to the site here. And they'll put them together, and eventually next week on the 23rd of September we'll open this whole village up so that the public can take tours and watch this competition. Meanwhile, we're here on a very busy site. We're glad it's not raining right now, and these teams are really excited to get their houses up. We're going to interview some of these teams over the next few days to see how they're progressing, building their houses on the mall, and then also interview them throughout the competition so that we can see how they're competing against each other in this very competitive competition. My name is Richard King, and I'm the director of the Solar Decathlon. I work for the U.S. Department of Energy. We're a proud sponsor of this event. The department works hard on researching solar technologies, energy efficient technologies, and these students are innovators, they're leaders, they're showing the way for us, and we're really proud of them out here. Hi, I'm over here now in front of the University of Maryland Watershed House. If you recall, they came in second place in 2007. They took a competition off and have studied hard, all the other teams, and they're out here to win the 2011 Solar Decathlon. They've got an amazing house, and we're going to talk to one of their team members here in just a second.
My name is Michael Feldman. I'm on the University of Maryland Watershed team. I am on the engineering team, and my responsibility was helping with the lighting design as well as any construction that I could help with. Watershed is, I think, one of the most exciting houses. It's what we've done is taken a multifaceted approach to sustainability and looked at our water use. Beyond being a net zero house, we feel is very important to consider our ecosystem, like the Chesapeake Bay watershed, and use water responsibly, which we've done with a green roof and constructed wetlands, as well as our landscaping, which really reduces our runoff and our impact on the watershed.
Hey, I'm Cole Hershkowitz on Team SciArt Caltech, an engineer on the team, and we partnered with the Southern California Institute of Architecture on this project.
My name is Brian Zentmeyer. I'm one of the two construction managers on the team. I'm from SciArc, so we are also the architecture side of the team. So CHIP is the compact hyper-insulated prototype. That's the design that SciArc and Caltech came up with together. And it plays off of the equation between consumption of energy and production of energy here at the Solar Decathlon. So our team chose to focus on making a hyper-insulated prototype, so something whose thermal performance was extremely high, hence the compact hyper-insulated prototype. And you'll notice you can't see it right now because we're just in craning and we're putting together the structural modules, but the core concept of the house is that it have an extremely high R value at an extremely low cost. So we have a very thick but inexpensive wall section, which you'll see in a few days. We hope it'll make a bit of an architectural splash.
I'm the measured contest captain for the SciArc Caltech Solar Decathlon team. And one of the things that we've really tried to do this year is design all our engineering systems so that we can get all 500 points on the quantitative competitions.
We have four international teams here with us this year. We have teams from Canada, China, New Zealand, and from Belgium. Team Belgium is from Ghent University. They're right next door to the Maryland team, and their concept is to build the house with just human labor.
My name is Charlotte Finke, and I'm responsible for the PR of the E-Cube house. We try to make a home that is very affordable, and in that way we focused on do-it-yourself. So the main cost of the house is the building cost and the hours of the people who are building your house. And we think that in Belgium the spirit is to do it yourself, and we are trying to make that shine from the E-Cube. so less cost. We are trying to have panels, the structural panels that are lightweight, so you can handle them with two persons. I'm carrying one with another girl, and it goes that way. And it's a very flexible house in that way, just because you can do it yourself, you can alter it yourself. So if you want to make a change in your house, like you want to change a door for a window or a wall for a window, that's possible. You can add a bathroom or a bedroom. We are with 40 people because we have to build it ourselves and it has to go very fast. Tonight you want to close the roof so no water can enter the house. And the boys started tonight and they have been working all night long. I think we are the only team who really started from scratch and is not putting a house together and prefab elements, but just structure first, then the walls, and later the interior. I think that's really the nice thing of this experience, that we are working together at this house and putting it together one by one.
So my name's Nick Officer. I'm here with Team New Zealand, one of 26 students that have travelled almost 9,000 miles with our house that you see behind us. We came in last night at 11 o'clock with our foundations and our first of six modules that this house has broken into. And now we're just finishing those modules off and we're about to clad the building and build our timber canopy, which will come to full glory in a few days' time.
So we've seen a lot of action here today, and these teams are going to keep working around the clock 24/7 for the next few days. We're going to keep tuning back in here to see their progress. One thing is clear, this is a workforce development program beyond no other. These are the next energy leaders of tomorrow.